So it's finally here. Premiere of the lost season.
Yes.
We've been talking about it and working on it, and now it's time.
It is.
I know. It's exciting.
And so, you know, we're just like all on pins and needles
we
to see
are.
How this thing comes
so
out.
Different for us. This is totally not how things...
We don't work in film.
Exactly. We've learned a lot.
So we have.
That makes that different from theater, but my goodness, so many folks really just stepped up so big.
Yes. You know, when we were sitting around in that meeting that day and just like brainstorming some ideas, and we kind of said, hey, what if we did a mashup and did like a fundraiser? And we did.
And it all kind of
like within just a couple of days.
Yeah. And then folks really, just everybody we asked said, we would absolutely love to help you with that. And and they did. And so it was amazing. So what we've done is we've recorded some folks doing an original script that was written for us. It's called The Lost Season. And it's about all the shows that we intended to do in 2020 and didn't get to do, of course. So it's pretty funny, just
and when we
the idea.
Said, like the lost season, then we started thinking, oh, like what other lost, like what could we kind of put with it? And so it ended up being like the cast of those shows with the castaways of Gilligan's Island.
Right. Which
so
is
kind of a funny mashup.
So that's terrific. So we did this in a very short window of time.
Very short.
We told our folks that they did not have to memorize their lines.
Right.
It would be more like a reader's theater because we wanted to not put a whole lot of pressure on them.
Right. We tried to tap people that theater isn't something they usually do. And they're just community members. So
that's
we wanted to
are.
Make it as low stress as possible.
Yes. So they so you'll see that they're reading their scripts, and that was part of the deal. We had one rehearsal. So they did this with just one. We read through it once, and then we did one rehearsal, and then...
And we didn't actually get through it all. So some of it, they were doing it for the first time.
Yes. So it's lots of challenges. they rose to it every single time. We did this on a zero budget.
Zero.
We didn't want to spend
any money. Because it's a fundraiser.
So, and then like we said, for most of these folks, it was their first time to do anything like this. They talked about that a lot, just stepping out of their comfort zone to help us do
and
this.
We saw some really fine talent too.
We're
gonna
now
be
on
like
the radar.
That's
good to come do things with us. So that's what you're going to see today is just some really good-hearted, good sports community leaders who said yes, we will raise money for you, and yes, we will come act and
we'll come be
whatever
silly.
It is you're talking about. We'll be silly. Exactly. we will do that for you. So we are grateful to them. They raised a lot of money.
Yes.
And it's really, we need it so much. It's been a hard year.
And we bought a building.
Right before COVID.
Right.
So good idea. Right? So that was fun. So they all worked really hard and they've all raised a lot of money. But we did have one fundraiser who kind of went above and beyond.
Yes,
really.
He did.
He raised the amount we asked him
and
to.
And you know, we cast him very well.
We did.
Because he plays a very extra character.
So Tim Stark from the Murray Bank raised the most money.
Yes.
From the 13 fundraisers we had.
So he plays Buddy the Elf. So we thought this would be a very fitting prize for Buddy the Elf. I think
he'll
be very excited.
He will be very excited
about being our top fundraiser.
Yes.
So thank you so much to everyone and to Tim for really hitting it out of the ballpark.
Absolutely. So, all right. So that's who's doing this project and kind of how the project came to be. So once we got into it and started filming it, we realized that most of the characters you're going to recognize. Dolly Parton from 9 to 5, Buddy the Elf from Elf the Musical, Helen Keller from The Miracle Worker. Those were shows we planned to do. So those characters you know. But we thought, a couple of those characters in those shows are not things that are really going to be familiar to you. So we wanted to really quickly just kind of touch on that. So we did Matilda. That was the first show of 2020, and we did get to do that.
Mm-hmm.
And then we were actually in Tech Week. That means the week the show was meant to open for a show called The Curious Incident of the Dog in the Nighttime, which is one of the most unusual titles, right, in all of theater. So you will see that character. His name is Christopher, and he is a teenage boy who has a form of autism. It's not really ever named, but he does have a form of autism. He's brilliant. He's very good at math. And he is investigating the murder of a dog in his neighborhood. And that's what his story is based on. So you will see that character. You will hear him kind of reference the dog, whose name is Wellington. So we wanted to kind of give you that background of that show.
Right.
And then another show.
Another show, Toxic Avenger, the musical. Sounds like a crazy title, and it's a crazy show. But you will see things from that show in our mashup show, too, because in the Toxic Avenger show, it's like a professor type gets turned into this Toxic Avenger, like a mutated kind of thing. Yeah. And a blind librarian falls in love with him. So you'll see, like, you'll see references to that in our mashup, too.
Right. Exactly. And then finally, the third one that we wanted to mention is called Murder Room. And it is a comedy. We found a great line about it. Someone said that it is a mix-up between Agatha Christie, Abbott and Costello, and Monty Python. So you can imagine how silly that play is. So that character's name is Mavis. And she, in the play, kills people.
It's the murder room.
Maybe. I mean, you know. Does she? We don't know. So you will see that as well. And so that's her character. That's what she's doing, mixing up some poison, maybe looking for her next victim. So just a fun, fun character. So we wanted you to have that background, and so it kind of makes some things make more sense.
And we hope you enjoy the show.
Thanks for
you
watching.
You can still give to Playhouse
Absolutely.
In the Park. And thank you for your support.
Thank you.
Just sit right back and you'll hear a tale that's a little nuts, that started when our season changed cause COVID really sucks. The aim was a slightly silly plan, it's crazy, that's for sure. Most volunteers up on this stage you've never seen act before, never seen act before. The Playhouse started doing stuff, the tiny place we thought, if not for the courage of a fearless few, it really could be lost. It really could be lost. Here we are up on this stage. We're gonna try to make you laugh with dancing and a joke or two. A love affair and a knife. A movie star. This show's better than Fry's fan. We hope you stay for a while.
It's January 2020, a whole new year ahead of us here at Santa's Workshop. It's gonna be the best, happiest, most productive year ever.
How are the new social media posts coming, buddy?
Oh, hey, Pom Pom. Okay, I guess. Thanks for promoting me from toy maker to social media coordinator.
Well, I figure since you and your biological dad are in publishing, you'd have a way with words.
Yeah, I'm just not good with typing them.
How many words have you typed today, buddy?
1, 2, 3.
Use word count, buddy. First, you highlight the paragraph.
How do I highlight?
Just click at the beginning of the sentence with your mouse.
This is a Mac. It doesn't have a mouse.
I thought it had a wireless mouse.
We had to get rid of it because Buddy thought it was a robot mouse.
Yeah, I don't like mice. You can't trust them. I learned that in New York.
Wait, I have one for USB.
Awesome. Thank you.
This is a new Mac. You can't attach USB devices without an adapter.
I hate Macs.
Yeah, requiring adapters is just another cash grab by Apple.
Apples are delicious!
You got mail!
Yeah, an email!
Okay, buddy, we'll leave it to you. Remember, I need you to write at least 1,600 new Twitter posts by this afternoon and translate them in every language in the world.
Thanks, Pom Pom. Thanks, everybody. Okay, let's see. New email. Dear Mr. Buddy Hobbs, aka Buddy the Elf, greetings from Playhouse in the Park in Murray, Kentucky. We are a community theater that produces several shows a year. We'd be honored to tell your story. You're cordially invited to star in our 2020 season. If you would like to participate, please reply, and we will send a boat to the North Pole to pick you up. Pom Pom, Santa, Papa Elf, I get to go to Murray, Kentucky.
Hope it all goes well, buddy.
Thanks, Mr. Narwhal. What's the worst that could happen?
My pupil, Helen Keller, continues to grow into a brilliant and educated young woman. Despite being deaf and blind from infancy, she has learned to read and communicate. She can even speak aloud.
Miss Sullivan, I have a letter from my sister.
Well, thank you, Mildred. Huh. Murray, Kentucky. Mildred, do you and Helen have family in Kentucky?
I'm not sure, Miss Sullivan. I don't think we do now, but that there is time machine mail.
Oh, yes, I see. It's postmarked January 2020.
Oh, golly, Miss Sullivan. I've never gotten any time machine mail from 2020 before. 2020 must have been such a wonderful, marvelous, fantastic year that they didn't have time to mail to us folks from the past.
I hate to disturb your sister with her studies, but this must be important if it's time machine mail from such a mysterious year. Helen, a letter from 2020 has arrived for you.
Thank you, teacher. I wonder if it's from Meryl Street. For the longest time, she would write me letters asking if she could play me in something called an Oscar bait movie with time machine mail. But I haven't heard from her since the late 20th century.
Open it, sister, open it.
Mildred wants you to open it now.
They sent the letter in Braille. How thoughtful.
Dear Miss Keller, this is not Meryl Streep wanting to win another Oscar. Oh, thank goodness. We cordially invite you to our theater, Playhouse in the Park, to tell your amazing story. If you would like to participate, we will send a time boat to pick you up. Teacher, Millie, we're going to go to Murray, Kentucky, to a distant land in the future, full of bright possibilities. To Murray, Kentucky, in the year of our Lord 2020.
What's the worst that could happen?
Working 9 to 5, what a way to make a living, barely getting by. It's all taken and no given, you just use your mind, and they never give you credit. It's enough to drive you crazy if you let it.
Miss Clark, a letter marked urgent came for you.
Dang it, kid. You interns need to stay out of the studio when we're recording.
I'm sorry, Mr. Reeves. I loved you and Bill and Ted.
It's all right, Keanu. I've got enough 9-to-5 magic in me to last 1,000 more years.
Well, why don't you hire college-age interns instead of kids?
Because I'm Dolly Parton. I built an amusement park for kids. I created literacy programs for kids. Poverty.
Yeah, Miss Parton's changed my life. I'm going to ride the Wild Eagle roller coaster at Dollywood after I deliver this.
Wild Stallions!
It's Wild Eagle, honey. It's not
Wild Stallions!
It's not a stallion. It's an American Eagle. I pulled that eagle out of poverty. I taught it how to read. Roller coaster. Well, who's the letter from anyway, honey? I'm all ears.
It's from a theater called Playhouse in the Park in Murray, Kentucky. Dear Ms. Parton, we are huge fans of both your humanitarian work and legendary 64-year-long music career. We'd be honored if you would be our guest for the 2020 theatrical season. If you wish to join us, please reply and we'll send a boat to pick you up.
Well, that sounds like a hoot. You betcha I'll be there.
Well, why didn't they ask Keanu? Keanu made the Matrix. Keanu rides a motorcycle.
Maybe they will when you star in a Broadway version of the Matrix, darling. Babs, Marla, we're going to Murray.
All right!
Miss Parton, can Keanu come with us? I love his hair.
Oh, and I love his eyes.
And I love his stubble.
And I love his Matrix.
Ew, girls, cut that out. Not in front of my intern. Of course, Keanu can come.
All right!
Yippee!
We're going to Murray! Woo!
not in front of me.
Sorry, Keanu, that was a test to see if you could keep your shirt on, and well, you failed, so you'll have to stay here.
This is why I lost a part of Wolverine to Hugh Jackman.
Aww. We're staying here!
All right. Let's finish this session up. More glass ceilings to break through. All right, ladies, in a 1, 2, 3, 4. Working 9 to 5. What a way to make a living.
Area code.
Woo! Hey, Mavis. You interested in going to a murder mystery? Sure. Excellent. Expect a boat called the Racer at the Victorian Embankment at noon tomorrow. Great. Oh, bloody hell.
I don't know why people have to talk using metaphors. Metaphors are confusing. People don't have skeletons in their closets. That'd be gross. Saying he is the apple of the eye doesn't make sense. Apples are for eating, but not the yellow ones. I don't like yellow things.
Hi, Christopher.
Oh, hello.
Your pet rat appears to be in fine health today. He's gotten so big.
Yes.
I've got a letter for you. It looks like it came all the way from Kentucky.
Kentucky?
That's in the United States.
I know.
Here you go, mate.
Thank you. Dear Christopher, you've been invited to tell your story in front of a live audience at our theater, Playhouse in the Park. Please come and share. If you wish to participate, there will be a boat waiting for you on the Victoria Embankment in London tomorrow at noon. We have enclosed an address, map, and train schedule to help you on your trip. Thank you. What do you think, Toby? Should we go? Mommy's house is near the Victoria Embankment.
Ah, smell that salty air, Angus. I love the Thames. The sun shining on its ancient waters as it winds through London. Think of the kings and queens who have sailed here. When I inhale this air, I practically gag on history. The universe is like the Thames. You and I, Angus, are like tiny drops of water rushing through time in an infinite circle.
Aye, Captain Hay, I were barely a fair from getting cholera.
Yes, good man, Angus. Give me a report on our English passengers. Have they all boarded?
What free hell no past you?
Excellent. So, they have boarded?
I dinna ken.
That's what I like to hear. You are the best chief officer I've ever had. So they have boarded and we are ready to set off.
You may ken loan not 5 words from my mouth, you fandan.
Good. Let us set sail, brave Angus. If the passengers have boarded and good, they have, and or will board, and we shall not leave without them, for they have boarded, or not.
Is this the Racer?
Yes, madam. I am Captain Church, the commander of this remarkable vessel. Are you the mysterious Mrs. T we have been expecting?
It's Miss, not Mrs., and I was told to arrive here at noon.
As punctual as she is beautiful. I love British manners.
And I just love Americans, both good-mannered and bad-mannered.
Angus! Carry Miss T's luggage to her cabin. Transfer it as gently as you would a delicate yet sensual crystalline tear dropped from the eye of a distant god. Come with me, my lady. I shall give you the tour.
Angus, grab the luggage. Angus, put it on the mask of man and take the pilot's for me.
Disgusting.
Hello, is this the Rachel bound for the U.S.?
Right you are. Great ship. Sealeth my not part of life. What you do then?
Thank you. Toby and I have never been on a boat before.
No. Well, I cannot say it's a rat or a hill hole.
Toby is my best friend, and if anything happens to him, I have a very specific set of skills, and I will find who did it.
It's a pure band three as long as it doesn't eat me.
I will be on board. Remember what I said.
I didn't mess with nothing. Woo!
Angus, are we under attack? I will defend this ship and this beautiful woman with my life. Shirtless.
I can quite take care of myself. Trust me.
That Burns be ragging rat scared the bejabers dry to me.
Yes, I agree. That rat is adorable. Make sure it gets on board safely. Time for announcements. Esteemed passengers, this is your captain, Seamus T. Church. We are about to embark. I have gathered you from all corners of the world. The icy North Pole, Pigeon Forge, and now jolly old England. But we have one more horizon we must cross before arriving in the Bluegrass State. We will boldly go where no man has gone before.
Ah, you bums out of the wind. Captain should not split infinitives, you numbthreak.
Right you are, Angus. We will go boldly where no man has gone before, other than time mail delivery men, and people in a flying DeLorean, and British Time Lords in blue phone boxes, and two teenagers in a different phone booth, and some people in a hot tub. Yes, where few men have gone before, my crew and I have converted this ship into a time boat. We are traveling back to the late 1800s to pick up a historic American national treasure, Helen Keller. Buckle your seatbelts.
Time travel? This national treasure is not okay with that.
Here we go.
Wait for me, I'm an adorable British girl who has supernatural powers!
Welcome to the late 1890s, intrepid voyagers. Please join me in welcoming the historic American national treasure, Helen Keller, to our ship, the Racer, on its maiden voyage through time. Welcome our honored guests, Angus. You'll have to forgive my chief officer. This is our first time using the Racer as a time boat. His internal system was not prepared. Yes, dear rat, comfort Chief Officer Angus.
Perhaps we should give your chief officer something to ease him.
Yes, you're right. Give him the rat.
I have some laudanum.
No laudanum. It's highly addictive. Let's return to Murray to what is known as a Walgreens to buy him some Tylenol.
Come on, Helen. Let's go below.
No time, madam. We're on a tight schedule. Never fear, it is perfectly safe on the deck of a time boat.
I really think we would prefer to go below deck.
Buckle your seatbelts.
What's a seatbelt?
Captain's log. The Racer has crash landed on a deserted island. Crew and passengers are all uninjured. Unfortunately, the newly installed time travel device malfunctioned, and myself and Chief Officer Angus have
pure dead brilliant. Meaning it doesn't mean hurt like we've been steaming drunk for the last 20 years.
For reasons unknown, Chief Officer Angus and I have regressed to our youthful forms. My hair and skin are glowing. The ship crashed somewhere between 1899 and 2020, but I have no way of knowing what year we are currently stranded in.
Captain, the snow on this island is so fantastic. You can play and play and play and never get cold. But watch out. Don't get any in your underpants. It chafes.
That is sand, buddy. There are 10,000 times more stars in the universe than grains of sand on Earth. Also, I can't stop craving candy. I want my mommy.
You know what? I think I have some. Yes!
I know I found it. It's my
Captain and Chief, stop it! You don't want to end up on the naughty list, do you?
This is sad. Yodelay-dee-doo! The blue blanket. The blue blanket. It's sparkling all around us. Don't drink the blanket. De Beers! A diamond is forever. A diamond is a girl's best friend. Oh, I think you all are terribly underdressed. But I guess you can still join the tour. But beware, it's his island. His island.
Whose island? Where are we? What year is this?
His. It's his island, not mine. I've made so many tax-deductible donations, but they didn't name it after me. It's his island.
Tax-deductible donations, you say? For how much?
Are you okay? How long have you been here?
It was only supposed to be for 3 hours. 5 months in the sun, or has it been 5 years? Wilson would know. Wilson, how long have we been here? Oh, Wilson, you old flirt. He says he can't keep track of the time because I don't look a day over 25.
Oh, well, this is sad too. I don't think there's any cash in that purse anymore, and I don't think any of us will be getting off of this island anytime soon.
Don't worry, dear. I never carry cash. Just something to powder my nose. Ta-ta! Remember, beware him. It's his island. He wears red after Labor Day. Beware him. It's a trap. It's a trap.
Wait. Come back.
She's lost her mind. That's what happens when people are alone too long. They go batty.
Do you think we're in danger?
I think she's harmless.
What about that man? That man she says owns the island.
I don't think he exists. Perhaps we should arm ourselves just the same. Or are you still going to protect me, little man?
That's condescending, Miss T. And no, girls are gross.
Ha! That's what I thought, love. Don't worry. I have a machete in my suitcase.
Wait, what?
Good grief. Look, Skipper, new humans.
I don't have to look. I can feel their presence.
Why do you hit me in the head and kick the Skipper?
You attacked us!
Oh, yeah, it's a good thing my buddy Little Gilligan here doesn't have any brains left to hurt.
Hearing that, where is that laughter coming from?
I don't hear anything.
Oh. Yeah, what laughter?
Kenny Cat, Arthur, Gad Gaddafi, or we're rockets.
We must be surrounded by hostiles.
Yes, hostile beasts. That's what me and the Skipper were running away from.
We were trying to put these curtains up on stage and we've disturbed a hive of bees.
Did somebody say stage?
Wow, Dolly Parton, you're more famous than the mosquitoes.
It's an honor, Mrs. Parton.
Would you headline our show tonight? We put on a show every week to cheer everybody up until we get rescued. Tonight, the honeybees were going to perform, but Miss Hallow has run off again.
Well, lead the way. I am bored to death in that death trap of a time boat, waiting for the Hardy Boys here to figure things out.
The Racer is a state-of-the-art vessel. Both seaworthy and wormhole ready.
Your ship hit some bad weather? Huh? Well, what happened to us?
I don't think our crash landing was more to do with human error than the weather.
I assure you, madam, both myself and Chief Officer Angus are highly certified in time travel.
But Officer McFlake, the pronoun, yeah, Bomet, it's I and Chief Officer Angus.
You'll have to forgive my Chief Officer's inherently inarticulate dialect. He's from Scotland.
Well, you look at me and away again like.
You're captain, but you're like 4 years old.
Yes, that's your problem. Hiring kids to sail, it ain't like selling lemonade.
I assure you, sir, that I'm presently at least 8 years old. Maybe 9. I was sailing through the uncharted fifth dimension when our ship malfunctioned. What's your excuse for wrecking? Did your belly block your view of an iceberg?
Hey, don't talk to the skipper that way.
Y'all are like a bunch of swordtail cats in a room full of rocking chairs. Stop this pissing contest and get us back on the boat. We've got a show to do.
Yes, ma'am. You heard, Mrs. Parton. Gilligan, get the bags. I want to see the inside of this time boat.
Don't touch anything on my boat, you hand-fisted whale.
Santa! You shame!
Enough with the fat jokes.
Santa, I have so much to tell you. First, I swam through the sea of swirly, curly gumdrops. And then I went through the candy cane forest. Through the sea. Oh, Santa.
How do they know who you are?
Because I'm Dolly Parton, honey. We're stranded in the 60s. I've already been a country music star for over a decade. Thanks to sunscreen, makeup, and science, I look exactly the same way as I did then.
Well, how do you know it's the 60s?
Well, we're on Gilligan's Island. I guess you're too young to remember when it was on TV. These poor people have been stuck here for years.
Gee, Professor, the skipper and Gilligan have been gone so long. Do you think we should go look for them?
Bees are amazing creatures, Marianne. When disturbed, they can chase somebody for almost up to a mile. I suspect and imagine that Gilligan and the skipper have run all the way to the shore.
My makeup has gotten so old, and I want to look my best tonight. It's just so clumpy.
Well, you can always do what Mrs. Hal does. A little sand to the face.
Oh, Marianne, that's not funny. She's a very ill woman. Plus, I've tried it anyway.
So did I. Makes my skin too dry.
I have a surprise for you two, my favorite girls.
Oh? Oh, another coconut.
Thank you. We love your inventions.
No, look. It's makeup.
Oh, look, Ginger. How wonderful. How did you do that?
Well, as you know, the coconut is a very versatile fruit.
Oh no. Coconut?
Yes. Usually I incorporate the shell, but inventions also have the fleshy part as well sometimes.
I'm allergic to coconut oil.
Well, for the lipstick, I took the flesh and ground it into a fine pulp. Once I achieved the consistency, I added some pigments I created from locally sourced seashells.
Professor!
And voila! All natural.
Oh no, my throat is closing up. Professor, you're explaining Ginger to death again.
Oh, sorry. I'll get the epinephrine.
Oh, Ginger, are you okay? Don't die. You haven't gotten your Oscar yet.
Oh, my. I'd like to thank the Academy and my makeup artist, Velma, for never poisoning me, and sweet baby Jesus.
Oh, she'll be okay. Come on, Ginger. Let's go get some water. And then we can gargle it and pretend like it's champagne.
Okay.
Did somebody say champagne?
Oh, false alarm, Mr. Howell. I was just dreaming aloud.
Aw, what a shame. I would give anything for a drop of the old bubbly and a side of caviar.
Well, I've actually improved upon my coconut champagne if anyone would like any.
No.
Here's the stage, Miss Parton.
It's Dolly Parton. We've been rescued by Dolly Parton.
Oh, no big deal, honey. I save a lot of people.
Parton? Parton, that name sounds familiar.
Dolly Parton? Where?
I never forget a name. By any chance, were you a debutante? Maybe we danced at a society event in my youth.
Oh, no, honey. I may look like I have champagne taste now, but I grew up on a baloney budget.
Ah, new money. A shame. I thought I'd finally found someone on this island I could have a civilized conversation with.
You can have a civilized conversation with me.
Well, good evening, madame. Thurston Howell III here. Do we know each other?
No, but I want to know you. I love traveling in aristocratic circles. Miss Mavis Templeton.
Well, I am flattered and enchanted. I wish my wife, Lovey, was here to make your acquaintance.
Oh, you're married?
Yes, and she's not feeling well right now. She's gotten too much sun.
You lady do.
Ah, that's her now. Poor thing. She's always had a beautiful yodel. She learned while we were on a ski trip in Switzerland.
Oh, I think I had the pleasure of meeting your wife on the beach.
Oh, I'm sure my angel will feel better when we get back to civilization and she can get some rest.
Rest in peace, hopefully.
Pardon me?
Thurston, would you show me to where I can put my bag? Lay my head tonight, perhaps somewhere near where you sleep. You make me feel so safe.
Certainly, dear. It's clear you belong on Lovey and my side of the island and not down here with all this rabble.
That girl right there is a Jolene girl if I've ever seen one.
Who's Jolene?
Oh, she's some homewrecker I'll write a song about 10 years.
Did you say 10 years? I think the coconut oil is making me hallucinate.
Miss Barton came here on a time machine.
It's definitely making me hallucinate.
Did someone say time machine?
Well, it aspires to be one. Right now, it's a glorified piece of marine litter.
Oh, I would love to take a look at it. Maybe I can help repair it.
Well, go for it, Goblin. Just follow our footprints to the beach.
That ship is never getting fixed.
Let's not focus on the negatives, okay? As long as we have a stage and some performers and Carl, we'll be just fine, girls.
Miss Parton, would you like to join our group and be a honeybee?
Well, of course. It'd be my honor.
Yay! I know all your songs. Back at the room on the farm, I have all your records.
Oh, honey, what's wrong, sweetheart?
I know this is shallow, but you're just so beautiful. And I look like I've been coughed up by a sick seagull.
Oh, honey, that is not true. In fact, I say with 100% honesty, you look unrealistically good for a castaway.
It's kind of spooky, actually, in the best way.
It is spooky, but as someone who embraces the unnatural, I respect it.
If only we had some fresh makeup and fresh skin care, that would make her feel better.
Well, say no more, Gilligan. Bring my bag. I have some makeup right in here.
Oh, Miss Parton, you're so generous.
Oh, nonsense. I've got more in this bag and more down at the beach.
Is that all you brought on your trip?
Oh, of course not, honey. I brought my custom microphone.
Let's get ready for the show. Yes, let's do.
Well, Gilligan, honey, you're filthy. With all that rolling around on the beach and messing with the bags.
And the bees.
Do you have any clothes to change into?
Oh, yes.
Oh, I didn't realize you were wearing layers. Weren't you hot?
A little. I kind of still am.
Well, I guess we can make a coat. A coat of many colors.
I just wear red.
The thing about boats is they're always sending me off. Gilligan!
I'm not Gilligan! I'm the professor!
Oh, sorry, force of habit. Gilligan's usually the one stepping on my hands or tripping me or gnashing my toes or...
What is that wonderful smell?
Oh, hello! I'm Roy Hinckley.
I'm sorry, I don't think we've met.
Miss Keller can't hear you. She's deaf and blind. If you want to communicate, put her hand on your mouth so she can read your lips.
Hello, I'm Roy Hinckley.
Hello, Mr. Hinckley.
Please, everyone calls me the professor.
All right, professor. I don't mean to be rude, but what is that wonderful smell coming from your clothing?
I'm not sure. This morning I crafted some lipstick using coconut oil extract. Maybe there's still some on there and on my hands.
Forgive my impertinence, but... Oh, it's marvelous. It's so fresh and so sweet. Oh, you know, I've never touched a coconut before.
Oh, well, it's an incredibly diverse fruit. Hold on.
Yes, well... It was very nice to meet you, Professor. Miss Keller is very tired from her journey.
Well, where is she from? Where is she going?
Apparently, we're not going anywhere tonight.
No, indeedy not, Miss Sullivan.
Professor?
Your ship is out of commission.
Professor?
Lead the way, Skipper. I need to get Helen to bed.
I'll escort you. It'd be an honor for me to escort Miss Keller to bed. I mean, to her room.
Not necessary. Good night.
Professor?
Come on,
lead
the way,
Skipper.
Professor?
What a strange coincidence that there's another Helen Keller. Her parents must have quite the sense of humor.
Don't say a word or you're a goner. What year is this?
I'm sorry, friend.
Where are we?
I don't know the exact answer to either question.
Don't be a smart aleck.
We are on a deserted island somewhere off the western coast of the United States. We've been here so long, I've actually lost track of the exact year.
Give me your best guess.
We were shipwrecked in 1964, that's all I know.
Well, that's just great. Perfect.
I assume you're one of the time voyagers who arrived today?
Sort of. I got wind that my cousin was hired to captain a time machine, so I stowed away. My plan was to commandeer the boat, take it back to 1939, and kill Hitler.
Well, that's a very admirable mission, but you do realize that if you kill Hitler and change history, you may erase your own existence.
I don't care. I'm just a cop from Miami who knows a little kung fu. The world doesn't need guys like me. Killing Hitler will save millions of lives.
Yes, but if you erase your own existence, you'll create a quantum paradox from which none of us can escape. Kind of like this darn island.
What's a quantum paradox?
Look at it this way. Let's say you're able to kill Hitler. Because World War II doesn't happen, your grandparents don't meet, your parents don't meet, you're never born.
Yeah, I know. So what?
If you're never born, then there's no one to go back in time to kill Hitler. So Hitler is able to rise to power, World War II happens, your grandparents meet, you're born, then you go back in time to kill Hitler again, and around and around and around we go. History will keep repeating itself and unrepeating itself. The world will get stuck and we won't be able to move on.
So, I should not try to go back in time and kill Hitler?
Correct.
So, should I go hide on the boat again?
Yes, unless you want to stay here with us. In the 60s, I've always kind of wanted to learn kung fu.
No thanks. With my luck, I'd get drafted into the Vietnam War.
The U.S. is still in Vietnam?
Yup.
Well, that really bakes my cookies.
Well, see ya. Don't tell me when I'm on the boat or that paradox thing might happen.
Well... If only the world could be solved with coconuts and a little elbow grease. I was trying to fix the boat, but when I ran out of candy, Captain Church and Chief Officer Angus yelled at me to get out of their way. Or at least I think that's what Chief Officer Angus said.
What you looking at?
I see 49 seagulls, 18 clouds, and 9 crabs. And one man dressed like a Christmas elf. I like Christmas.
I sensed you were a fellow Christmas enthusiast. What's your favorite Christmas movie? Mine's Miracle on 34th Street. What's your favorite Christmas carol? Mine's Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. What's your favorite Christmas color? On the count of three, let's say it together. Ready? 1, 2, 3, green! You don't talk much, do you?
I was thinking of the color I wanted to say. In the Judeo-Christian tradition, green represents the eternal life of Jesus Christ, as represented by the evergreen trees. Red represents the blood of Jesus shed during his crucifixion. In the dramatic Yule pagan tradition, green mistletoe stood for peace, and red represents the holy king that did the battle with the oak king.
Wow! You know a lot of cool facts. I said green because it's my favorite color.
Red, rats are colorblind and can't tell the difference between red and green.
Aw, that's sad. Can I pet your rat? What's his name?
Toby.
He's an impressive size, way bigger than the rats I saw in New York City, and those were huge!
He's on a strict feeding schedule. His next feeding is in exactly 15 seconds.
You're in luck! I have a treat for Toby. It's okay. It's from the original Ray's Pizza. Wait for the coup de grace.
Rats aren't supposed to eat pizza.
But it's got syrup.
Oh.
The rats in New York love it. Good point. The fish probably wants some too.
Domesticated rats have a very sensitive digestive system. If you feed them pizza, it can make them sick.
I'm sorry I've made you mad. You remind me of my little brother when I first met him.
I don't have a brother. My parents just had me, and then my mother left.
Yeah, my mom died when she was having me. I wish I would have known her. My dad didn't know about me until I came to visit him.
My dad told me my mom died, but she really just moved away.
I'm sorry. Sounds like your dad might be on the naughty list. My dad was too.
If there is a naughty list, he's most definitely on it.
Listen, we have a lot in common. I'm going to make you my honorary little brother.
Brother. A complex relationship to propose. Cain killed Abel, but Wilbur and Orville Wright built an airplane.
Yeah, I need to write to Papa Elf right now and tell him to get the guest room ready for my new brother.
I'm telling you, Angus, something is afoot. When we first inspected the ship after wrecking, only the turn device was malfunctioning. And now it appears that someone has cut power to the bow thrusters. Governor Brooks to Vigilance. Yes, Angus, you're right. We should try to find some more candy.
You think someone sabotaged the ship?
Possibly.
But who would do something naughty like that?
That bloody roleplay killed Taylines.
To find out who did it, we need to uncover everyone's possible motives.
Ooh, what's a motive?
Come on, buddy. Let's go on board and look for clues.
Oh, look! Another human!
Last time I checked.
Christopher, maybe he has a motive.
He appears to be another castaway. He stinks of coconut oil, but I can detect any smells associated with the boat. Can you, Toby?
Ooh! I love coconuts! So white inside, like fresh snow.
I'm the professor.
A professor of what exactly?
Well, I have degrees in chemistry, botany, biology, psychology, and geography.
You must be a genius.
Maybe you're an evil genius.
Hardly. I'm here to see if I can help repair your ship.
Professor, we'd be grateful for any assistance you can provide. I should have hired a science officer for this,
voyage, but they don't come cheap these days.
You're the captain?
Yes, this is so embarrassing. When our time device malfunctioned, it returned me and my chief officer, Angus, to our usual forms. Airplane in the baby.
What are coconuts for?
Well, they're a very versatile fruit. I found them to be quite useful here on the island. Could I make a rocking horse out of one of them? Oh yes, I've made many things out of them. An electric generator, a Geiger counter, a battery recharger, a sewing machine, a washing machine, and a hot air balloon.
It's probably how he's talking to me. Yes, I trust them too, Angus. Welcome aboard, sir.
Who is the architect of these artificial snowflakes? Craftsmanship is exquisite.
I made them when everyone else was asleep.
Well, they're certainly strong. I think you and I should compare notes.
Oh, it'll be me. He's counseling the draft elf wild part. Come, Professor. I shall give you the tour. By the way, do you have any candy on you?
I liked him. He appreciated my snowflakes.
Let's go, buddy. We need to solve the mystery of who is sabotaging the racer.
Oh, so sorry to disturb you, Miss Templeton. Gilligan told me you said it was urgent.
Oh, please, Thurston, call me Mavis.
Oh, I'll come back later when you're awake. Maybe you can take a stroll on the beach and talk more about my stock portfolio.
Oh, don't run off, Thurston. We've become friends, haven't we? Oh, Thurston, you always put me in the best mood. You bring out the best in me.
Oh, you're very sweet. Mm. Are they usually this affectionate in England?
No, not usually. We're usually very buttoned up. And I need to confess something to you. Your devotion to your insane and very elderly wife is quite touching. But to think of it, Thurston, with my knowledge of the future and your millions, well, we could become the ultimate power couple, rich beyond our wildest dreams, thanks to the stock market.
Oh, I'm sorry, Miss Templeton, but I will never be unfaithful to my lovey. Even if she has gotten too much sun.
Thurston, she's gone completely mad. What are you going to do once you're rescued? You can't take her out in public. A quickie divorce is in order for you.
Oh, I will never divorce my lovey. Mm. In my wedding vows, I promised until death do us part, and I meant it. Mm. Good day, Miss Templeton. Good day.
Until death do us part, until death do us part. That's exactly what I had in mind.
Thank you for meeting me here, Professor. I have so wanted time alone.
As have I.
My teacher is very protective.
I want you to know I would never do anything to disrespect you.
But I want you to be improper, Professor. You do not know what it's like for my fingers to touch your mouth, but never to touch my lips.
I have been looking for Miss Keller everywhere.
I wanted to show Helen my garden so that she could smell the flowers. This is where I grow all the plants for my experiments.
Hello, teacher.
Well, isn't that nice? I'll join you.
The professor was just showing me his garden.
It's quite lovely. Let's all enjoy it together. I knew a great professor once who invented the telephone.
You don't say.
Where is it that you are from, Professor Hinckley?
Traumaville, New Jersey. How about you, Miss Sullivan? Where are you from?
The professor says that he thinks our ship will not be fixed.
Yes, it's...
It's unclear to me how a man who cannot fix a regular old boat is able to fix a time machine.
People keep bringing this up. Unfortunately, I don't have the materials to fix the SS Minnow. I've tried every configuration of coconut possible.
Can't you cut down one of these trees? Isn't the boat made of wood?
Huh.
Somebody scream or this guy gets it.
What?
Professor?
Let me guess. You're a time traveler trying to kill Hitler.
Scream.
Oh!
Yeah. Is this the year 1939? Are we anywhere close to Berlin?
What's happening, Professor?
Oh, no, you fool. I'm trying to research him.
Who's Hitler?
Try to research him?
I'm Daniel Day Lewis, the greatest method actor of the 20th century. I have won 3 Oscars playing historical figures, and I want 1 more. In order to play Hitler perfectly, I must meet him.
Well, I'm sorry, friend. We are on a deserted island sometime in the 1960s.
Blast it! My kung fu trainer told me that his cousin had procured a time machine. I stowed away, hoping I could take commandeer the boat and take it to 1939.
What happens in 1939 that's so important?
Don't tell her. Revealing the future might change the outcome of history.
What am I supposed to do now? Ever since this boat crash, I've been hiding in this garden.
Maybe you could research something else to pass the time.
I suppose I could do a character study of someone else on the island. It's just all of you seem so cartoonish, very two-dimensional characters.
This is the 60s. What do you expect?
I'll be in my trailer. And by my trailer, I mean in these bushes.
How very odd. I don't think Miss Keller and I should linger here.
I agree.
I really must speak to the Captain Church about security on board this time machine. Too many stowaway time travelers.
Oh, Wilson, this is so romantic. Tell me again about Paris and your mother, Chanel. What was she like? Wilson, I can't kiss you. I'm a married woman. I know my Thurston is insane and extremely elderly, but I love him dearly.
The footprints lead this way. Toby, do you smell anything? Yes, I smell it too. A sickly sweet perfume that is very familiar.
I think we're hot on the trail of one of those motives, Christopher.
Look what Toby found.
A motive!
Not a motive, but a clue for sure.
Should I take one for the team and taste it, you think?
No, I'm 99% sure that dart is tipped with deadly poison.
Maybe we should go back to the beach where it's safe from all these motives.
Come on, brother. We gotta solve this before some cute dog gets hurt.
Oh, Wilson, that is too droll. Apologize to Mr. Goodyear. He'll leave the tea party. Mr. Goodyear, I am so thrilled that you and Caroline have gotten engaged. Caroline, who's designing your dress? Bloody hell.
Hello, Mrs. Howe.
Goodness gracious. It's very rude to come up to a tea party uninvited.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Howe, but we're here on police business.
Police? Police? What a scandal. What will people think?
We are looking for motives.
Well, you won't find any here. Leave at once. Go. Yodel-a-hee-doo!
Well done, Toby. You found another clue. It's strange. It's that strange perfume again. Buddy, I think someone is trying to murder Mrs. Howe and keep us stuck on this island.
But why? Why would anyone want to hurt Miss Howe?
Don't worry, Mr. L. Macy's doesn't open for another hour. You won't be late for the parade.
I don't know, but we're going to find it out. She will not go the way of Wellington.
Helen, the boat is almost fixed, but I don't want you to leave.
I don't want to leave you either. But you said yourself, if I don't go back to my time, it may change history and erase your existence.
I know I said that, but the fact is, if I don't have you, I don't want to exist.
Hello, teacher.
Look at the lovebirds. Cheep, 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 cheep. Better marry soon, Professor.
It's not your chaperone, it's Mrs. Howe.
Oh, hello, Mrs. Howe. How is Wilson?
He's been a very bad boy. A very bad boy indeed.
Oh! 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 It burns! Helen! Helen, it burns!
Roy! Roy, what's happening? What's wrong?
Holy moly! That is a motive if I've ever saw one!
This is a fresh crime scene, buddy. Toby, stay away from that liquid on the ground. It stinks of poison and perfume. I say whoever made that poison uses perfume as an ingredient.
Death by stinky perfume.
Roy!
Not a good way to go.
Roy, where are you?
Don't worry, dear. Looks on everything. He has brains, too.
Miss Keller is upset. Evidently, the professor was just here and quickly left.
Maybe he's the naughty one.
I was just thinking the same thing, buddy. He tried to kill Mrs. Howe with the poison and fled when he saw us coming.
What should we do now?
We've got to stop him before he escapes on the time boat. That must be his plan. What's the quickest way to the beach?
We can cut through the stage area, but I think Miss Parton's play is about to go on.
If we don't stop him, it might be curtains for all of us.
Christopher, you just used a metaphor.
I know, and I hate myself.
Helen, where have you been? Where have you been?
Off with the professor again?
Where is the professor?
He's probably at the show. Everybody is at Mrs. Parton's show.
Take me to him. I must see if he's okay.
The show? La, 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 la. I'm a honeybee. Can't be a show without the honeybees. Wilson! Wilson! Where's my hippie wig?
Come on, buddy. I think he went this way.
Is he here? Is the professor here?
I don't see him. Good riddance.
Angus, I think I just have about fixed.
Working 9 to 5, what a way to make a living. Barely gets me by. It's all taken and no given. They just use your mind and they never give you credit. It's enough to drive you.
You fixed it, Captain, you roasted macaroon.
Still not working, old boy? I'll try it again.
Rock and roll!
You need us like a clown needs a shell, like a prisoner needs a cell, like a ding-dong.
I followed you here because I want to workshop Matrix the Musical.
Honey, you're here to rescue us from the 60s. That musical can wait.
Well, Sillions!
Who is this Keanu guy? I think he's kind of cute.
He is kind of cute. He's got some charisma, but like a movie star that always plays the same character.
The professor isn't here, Christopher.
Yes, if he'd gotten here before us, the boat would already be gone. I'm missing something.
Missing a motive?
Yes, exactly. Let's think this through. Who would want to kill Mrs. Howe? Who would have the most to gain?
Mr. Howe wouldn't. He loves her.
Yes, I think we can eliminate any of the castaways who are here before we arrive as suspects. The attempted murder is one of us?
Me or you?
No, one of us. Someone who arrived on the boat.
What about Captain Church and Angus? No, they've been too busy, and they don't have a reason to hurt Miss Howe.
I agree. Helen Keller wouldn't try to murder someone with throwing stars and blow darts.
And Miss Sullivan is always trying to catch Helen making out with the professor, so she doesn't have time to kill anybody.
Miss Parton has been working on rehearsing on the night show day with Carl. So that only leaves
one person.
Miss Templeton?
Yes, it makes sense now. Miss Parton said that you were alone with Jolene, a homewrecker. You want to marry Mr. Howe and stay here in the 60s.
Yes, then I'll finally be the richest and the fairest of them all.
You know what you're getting from Santa this year? Coal. Mm. Miss Templeton.
Perhaps, but I'll be able to buy myself plenty of presents once I marry Mr. Howe.
We're going to stop you.
Oh, no, you won't.
Not on my watch.
Professor, how did you survive the poison being dropped on you?
I am not the professor anymore. Your poison almost physically ought to be forever. Call me the Toxic Avenger.
Good God, it's hideous.
It's Boy! I smell him!
At least my beloved can't see me like this.
I still smell coconuts, but it's now rotten and putrid.
I love you, Helen, but I'm a monster now. A horribly smelly, disfigured monster.
Someone told me that looks aren't everything. Kissing? Gross!
Got around. Good news, the time boat is repaired, and we are ready to leave. Let the other castaways know we have room for them.
The other castaways and I have to stay here.
But why? We have to rescue you.
No, I was wrong and selfish. Myself, Ginger Marianne Gilligan, the skipper, and the Howes have to stay here. If we left the island early, it would change history and potentially erase the existence of millions of people on Earth.
So this is goodbye?
Yes.
And I will always love you.
Miss Parton, we thought you left with Kim.
Carl and I couldn't both fit in the phone booth, and I couldn't leave Carl. He's my man.
Good. It looks like everyone is here. Climb aboard. I'll get the engine started.
Someone's got the line again.
This can't be happening. We solved the mystery. Mavis was vanquished.
I never sabotaged the boat. Someone else was doing that.
Santa!
Ho, ho, ho! I've come to rescue anyone who wants to fly back to 2020!
I'm perfectly capable of transporting everyone once my ship is fixed.
Well, hello, young man. And what do you want for Christmas?
I'm a grown man, sir, and I'll only tell you what I want while sitting on your lap in a respectable place like Macy's.
Santa, how did you get here?
Oh, Santa's the OG time traveler. How do you think he can reach every child's house all in one night, Dolly?
Climb aboard, everyone! What about her?
Don't worry about her. We'll take her back to 2020 end of bridge. once our ship is fixed again.
Don't worry, I'll protect little Captain and Chief Officer.
Okay, I'll show you a little clown about Bonnet.
Farewell! And to all, a good night!
Santa!
All right, I'm all right. Takes more than just a jumpy sleigh to hurt this old man. Buddy, take a look and see what's going on.
The engine is missing.
The saboteur is still on the loose.
What kind of monster would sabotage Santa?
Wait a second.
Gilligan, what are you doing?
Gee whiz, guys, I just wanted you all to stay on the island. Don't leave. You're like family now.
You were the one kept cutting the lines and breaking the ship?
Yes, I've been sabotaging escape attempts from the island so long I've gotten pretty good at it.
That's cold-blooded, Gilligan, and a little sociopathic.
I'm sorry.
Oh, creepy!
This sleigh engine is ruined. We'll have to use Christmas cheer to fly.
Santa, your coat is torn. Will you be warm enough?
Santa, I've got this one right here. It was supposed to be a coat of many colors, but it's just red. Perfect for you.
I look great in this color. That's perfect.
The best way to spread Christmas cheer is singing loud for all to hear.
Well, let's sing, everybody. Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer
Reindeer
had a very